Yeah, it was, like I said, it was easy for us this year. And we had one pitcher go down with an injury this year, and that kind of changed things up. It took Corey Burton out of his role in relief and put him into the starting role, which the way it worked out the last half of the year, with the exception of our second round game versus McDonough with a couple weeks to go, where we started our sophomore Travis Nail. I think we basically went Paul Corey, and the last few weeks into the playoffs, and it was pretty easy. And you know, Nick Richardson, who's going to be playing soccer at Maryland next year, is not a guy that's been talked about all year, but yeah, in 17 conference innings, he didn't give up an earned run. Yeah. He didn't give up a run, period, in 17 conference innings. That's pretty unbelievable. And he's a guy that was a starter for us as a sophomore and junior, but he was our starting second baseman this year. His role changed a little bit, and he's better suited for us in the bullpen, and was really, really good all year for us. And knowing that you had guys like Corey and Nick in the back end of the games, and after Corey came up having Nick out there, it's, you know, if you get a lead in the fifth inning, your game's over. That's what it seemed like. So
Corey brought a lot to the table. He did a lot of things for you. Plus, he was a character. He provided a lot of comedy, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He's an interesting kid. Kind of has that Napoleon syndrome. Little guy who's big personality. And he's a guy everybody loves. He's immediately, maybe the first time you meet him, it's a little bit of this kid crazy, and you realize, yeah, he is, but he's a lot of fun. And, you know, he's a great kid. I spent a lot of time around him in the last couple of years in the summer and fall playing outside of Curley. So it was, it's going to be sad when these kids, you know, or once they go off. You know, I'm hoping to see some of them play this summer, and we have a couple of guys playing the European League, some of the guys playing the MCBL. I'll be trying to keep up with them a little bit over the summer. Luckily, we have a couple of guys going to Towson, so we get to see them fairly regularly. So, but it's going to be sad seeing all these guys go. Been a group we spent a lot of time around, and I know it's kind of part of the deal, and you get used to it. But this is a special group.
Now, what about you, future? You going to continue to coach Curley forever
until they tell me they don't want me anymore?
There you go.
That's my plan. It's
a lot of people say your dad really coaches the team. I'm just kidding.
Yeah. He screws him up, and I have to, I've got no issues with anything about that. We're the same person in slightly different terms.
Does he ever argue with you? Or?
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah.
And the good thing is, I just tell him to shut up. I'm the head coach. No way. But no, he's a bit old school with things. Yeah. I'm a bit, you know, more modern with some ideas, but 99.9% of the stuff we agree on. We both compete, and we've always fought on the baseball field. That's just how we go. We didn't fight very much at all this year because there wasn't a whole lot to fight about. But, you know, 99% of what I know I learned from him, and, you know, he lets me be. He's always there for me to learn from it. The game, this game, if you think you know it all, then you're in trouble. And yeah, my first year, I relied on him heavily, and after my second year, I pretty much, you know, I ask him questions and get his input, but I have no issues going against what he thinks anymore, and that it is what it is. Sometimes he's right, sometimes I'm right, and there are no issues with that. But you know, it's unbelievable to have him here, the knowledge that he has, the experience that he has, and, you know, grumpy old man sometimes, but that's okay.
Now, as far as this season, and it was a great season, what are you going to remember about the season and then the feelings that you had when you and your dad, and I don't know of another, all the years I've been around high school baseball, another father-son combination, well, it's son-father, that kind of a combination, winning a major championship like you guys did.
Riverdale Baptist. Ryan Terrell's the head coach now.
That's right. There you go.
And we're friends. I mean, Ryan and I grew up playing each other. But no, it's a really great experience, and something that, you know, he's my best friend. All we do is, you know, we spend time together watching sports and yelling at the television and arguing about everything. And getting to have that experience with him is pretty special. Got to do it here twice as a player, and won a couple national championships in summer baseball, and never gets old. But I think the biggest thing for us is just going to be the guys and the relationships and the real team chemistry the team culture that we had this year. It was the kind of thing that didn't matter if you were having a bad day, everybody could figure that out. Everybody knew how to pick you up that day. And if somebody had a bad day on the field, it was over with. We never had a single issue with the kids. It was truly like a family. One day you can be mad at somebody, but you just shut up, move on, and get it over with. And just a really special group. They're kids that I think are going to be tight for a long time. And going to miss them. And I think that's going to be the biggest thing to take out of it.
Well, not taking anything away from them, but the Terrells never really played in the league. They've
right.
always been in
they the do their thing.
So you guys are the two that was in an organized situation. Well, Brooks, congratulations on a great year on behalf of Varsity Sports Network. I want to congratulate you and thank you for all your help. And also for the way you guided this ball club, because it was truly remarkable watching you guys play. I mean, like, somebody that had not seen you before and came for the first time to see you, they have to think, oh man, this is a ball club. I remember when Dean Albany, World Scout, saw you guys play early in the season, and I think he hit 3 or 4 home runs in a game. He said, Pat, have you seen him yet? And I had not seen you guys, and I saw you later. But that's just the kind of impression you gave everybody. It's like, hey, this is a ball club and it's out of play. And that's a reflection on you and the job that you did. Congratulations on behalf of Varsity Sports Network.
Thank you, really
good luck
it.
Next season.
Thank you.
This is Pat O'Malley for Varsity Sports Network.